So honestly, though, before we close, I have to say one of the things that you have taught me in all of our parenting conversations, and we've had them over the years, both for my personal parenting and for stories we've worked on together, is how you can have a conversation with your kid and feel like at the end of it, God, that went horribly. Like they're still acting like a jerk, or they still don't see things from my perspective, or that was just such a loss, waste of everybody's time. And you have helped me see it not that way at all, that like any of these conversations, even if you both leave them furious at each other, if it doesn't seem like anybody budged, it was worth having the conversation. You planted some kind of seed.
Yeah.
You opened a door that now they know is open. They can come to you with that topic again, or you can come to them with that topic again. Maybe you learned something
yep.
from them that you didn't know going in. It's always worth having that conversation.
Always worth it. No matter what it is, have the conversation. Don't shy away from it. And kids work in sound bites. So even if you walk away thinking, well, that was hopeless, nothing happened there, they might have picked up on something.
Yeah.
They might not show their hand right away. They might not even recognize that they picked up on something, but they
yeah.
probably did.
See, I love that. And I think that can be true of these cultural conversations too,
definitely.
Right? I think that there's some learning there for the way we talk about, you know, toxic masculinity or whatever the topic of the day is, that even if you left the conversation going like, I think exactly the same thing, and I think that person thinks exactly the
right,
same
right.
thing.
Nobody's changed anybody's mind.
That it's still worth trying,
yep.
and it's incremental, right? The learning and the progressing, it's incremental. You
it
don't
is.
Have to walk away going like, oh, wow, we're on the same page all of a sudden.
Think process, not moments. And
yeah.
and remember the kids work in sound bites, and things like this Gillette ad, things like what happened on the mall, these are great ways to talk to your kids, right?
Mm.
To hit the pause button and
yeah.
say, what do you think's going on here?
Yep.
You know?
Well, and you talked to your son about the Gillette ad. Talk about that for one second, because
yeah,
you said he didn't actually like it.
George and I had this little debate about whether this was really useful or not, or whether this was just manipulative and damning men. So we had to work that through a little bit. And I would say we're probably somewhere in the middle of that process. You
yeah.
know what I mean? That's probably something we're going to have to continue to talk about going forward.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I love using that stuff that's out there
yeah.
and people are buzzing about as, you know, a parenting tool too.
Definitely.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
For your time and for your insights. Thank you guys for joining us. We're here every Wednesday at noon, right here in the same spot. In the meantime, you can follow me on Twitter at HeidiStevens13. Read my columns at chicagotribune.com/balancingact and subscribe to the Tribune, chicagotribune.com/subscribe. Thanks, guys. See you next week.